طبعا يا جماعه الجي اي تي احنا خدنا في اول حاجه ذا فيرست ليكتشر كانت اباوت ذيس تيوب اند ذيس سبيسيمن ذيس از ا تانج فولود باي بارت اوف ذا فارينكس اند ات ذا فارينجو اوسوفيجيال جانكشن انتهى الفارينكس وابتدى وات ذا بيجينينج of the esophagus. This tube is the esophagus. The upper part of this tube is called cervical part of the esophagus, followed by the longest part of the esophagus is the thoracic part of the esophagus. The terminal 1 inch of esophagus is called abdominal part of the esophagus. The esophagus ends at this point, which is gastroesophageal junction. This opening is the cardia. Okay? After the esophagus, there is the stomach. The stomach is formed of lesser curvature, greater curvature. It has an upper end and a lower end. The upper end is called cardia. This lower end is called the pyloric sphincter. Okay. You should feel, all of you, the sickness of the cardia and feel the sickness of the pyloric sphincter. The pyloric sphincter can be identified by its pyloric thickening, thickening of circular muscle layer, because the pyloric sphincter has a true anatomical and the histological sphincter with the thickening of circular muscle layer. But here in the cardia, the thickness of the esophagus is the same as the cardia and the stomach. The stomach has two surfaces. The stomach is oblique like that, therefore it has an antero superior surface and postero inferior surface. The lesser curvature gives the attachment to lesser omentum, and the greater curvature gives the attachment to three-fold peritoneum. From the greater curvature upward, there is a fold of peritoneum called gastrophrenic. From greater curvature to the left, there is gastrosplenic. From the remaining of greater curvature downward, the greater omentum. There is the remaining part of this specimen. All this fold of peritoneum is the greater omentum, which descend downward to cover the small intestine and parts of large intestine. Okay, this is the greater omentum. Repeat, what is this tube? Esophagus. What is this organ? The stomach. This? Lesser. Greater curvature. Cardiac end. Pyloric end, which is the pyloric sphincter. And feel the thickness here and here. And two surfaces, an antero superior surface and postero inferior surface. Postero inferior surface, which is related to the stomach bed. Okay? Separated from the stomach bed by the cavity of the lesser sac. What is this? Stomach. Lesser curvature, greater curvature, cardiac end, pyloric sphincter, pyloric end, and antero superior and the postero inferior surface. Okay. This is a specimen for the upper abdomen. This is my right hand. On the right side there is the liver, and on the left side there is the spleen, and in between the liver and the spleen there is, this is the stomach in its anatomical true position. Okay, the stomach has this surface, which is in this specimen is a true specimen, as in the human body, in the living subject, because it is present within its relation. Therefore, you can see the obliquity of the stomach. The stomach is oblique. The stomach is oblique because the cardiac end is 10 centimeter depth from the anterior abdominal wall, while the pyloric sphincter is 1 inch, 2.5 centimeter from the anterior abdominal wall. Therefore, the stomach is oblique. Therefore, it has an anterior and posterior surface. It has an antero superior and the postero inferior surfaces. And the obliquity of the stomach is prominent in this specimen. This specimen show the antero superior surface and the posterior inferior surface, and posteriorly all the structures related to this posterior inferior surface is called the stomach bed. You see that the stomach is separated from the stomach bed by this cavity in which I put my hand. This cavity is the lesser sac. The stomach is related to two cavities. Cavity in front, when you open the muscles of the anterior abdominal wall, you will find this cavity in front of the liver, in front of the stomach, in front of greater omentum. All this cavity is the greater sac. But the small cavity here behind the stomach is the lesser sac. Okay? لا طبعا. يا جماعة, peritoneal cavity doesn't contain anything. احنا كنا بنقول ايه؟ The peritoneal cavity is a cavity doesn't contain anything except capillary fluid to lubricate the movement between visceral and parietal layer. If this fluid increase, it is a condition called ascites. Okay? We will take in detail in the theoretical lecture what is the peritoneum. This is the stomach. The cavity behind the stomach separating the stomach from the stomach bed is, this is the lesser sac. Okay. Okay. In this specimen, this is the thoracic organs separated from the abdominal organs by this muscle. This muscle, which is the diaphragm. On the right side, under the diaphragm, there is the liver here. Okay. And this cavitary organ, organ containing cavity. I open this cavity. What is this organ? This is the stomach, showing its mucosal rugae, large mucosal folds of the stomach. Okay. This is the liver and this muscle, diaphragm above the liver. This is the diaphragm, this is the liver, and this organ is the stomach. And this is the greater curvature, and this is the lesser curvature. Here we can revise the relation of the anterosubural surface. The anterosubural surface is divided into three areas. Area on the right side, area on the left side below the costal margin, and the area below the liver and the costal margin. The right area is related to left lobe of liver. While the area below the costal margin is related to diaphragm. And the area below the liver and the diaphragm is related to anterior abdominal wall. Okay. Let us go to the liver. The liver is a wedge-shaped structure occupying the upper abdomen. Right hypochondrium, epigastrium, left hypochondrium. The liver is divided into anatomically into large right lobe and the small left lobe by this attachment. This attachment is the attachment of falciform ligament, which is more prominent here in this line. This is the line of attachment of falciform ligament. Therefore, this is the large right lobe anatomically, and this is the smaller left lobe anatomically. More prominent in this specimen. And this is specimen, this is the liver. And this fold of peritoneum attached to the anterior and superior surface of the liver is falciform ligament. Falciform ligament. Therefore divided into the liver large right loop and small left loop. The liver is wedge in shape, which has right lateral surface, anterior surface, posterior surface, superior surface, and the inferior surface. Okay. The most important is posterior and inferior surface because it's related to many organs. When we look to the posterior surface of the liver, I reflect the liver like that, and we start from this is the left side and this is the right side. When I reflect the liver like that, it becomes this is the left and this is right. From left to right, this is the impression for this is the esophagus and this my stomach. If this represents the esophagus and the stomach, this is my hand. The esophagus is here. Enter the esophageal opening in the diaphragm, and the abdominal part of the esophagus is related to left lobe of liver. After the esophageal impression, there is a fissure. Fissure for ligamentum venosum. After the fissure for ligamentum venosum, there is a loop on the posterior surface of the liver, which is called caudate lobe of liver. To the right side, this tube lying in its groove, this is the groove for inferior vena cava. To the right side of the caudate lobe. After the caudate lobe of liver and the inferior vena cava, to the right side, there is a bare area. Bare area related to diaphragm and right suprarenal gland. Okay. As we mentioned in the theoretical notes, all the posterior surface is related to the diaphragm, except if there is a structure passing between the liver and the diaphragm. What is this structure passing between the liver and the diaphragm? Esophagus. And this structure? Inferior vena cava. And the small gland here which enter between the liver and the diaphragm, which is right subarachnoid gland. All other areas related to diaphragm, as the caudate loop related to the diaphragm and the bare area related to the diaphragm. After the esophagus, there is what? The stomach. This is the esophagus and the stomach, and the liver is here. Okay, if I reflect the liver, after the esophageal impression, if I descend to the inferior surface, what is this structure related to? This area related to the stomach and called the gastric impression. Actually, in living subject, the liver is very soft and resting here, related to gastric impression and related to the lesser curvature. And from the lesser curvature arising the lesser omentum. The soft liver for many years in all life, the soft liver is resting here in the lesser curvature and the lesser omentum. Therefore, resulting this bulge. This bulge is called bulge like a tubercle. Therefore, it's called tuber. Since it is related to the omentum, it is called the tuber omental. Okay. Okay, jamaa. Therefore, in the inferior surface, this is gastric impression for the stomach, and this bulge is called the tuber omental, related to the lesser curvature and the lesser omentum. After the esophagus, what is present in the GIT? The bilor-duodenal junction and the first part of duodenum passing here transversely, related to this lobe of liver. This lobe, which is quadrangular in shape and has four boundaries, therefore called quadrate lobe of liver. There is a fissure here related to this ligament. This is a fissure for ligamentum teres. Fissure for ligamentum teres. To the right side of the fissure for ligamentum teres, there is a quadrate loop, which is related to three structures. In the middle, related to bilor duodenal junction and the first part of duodenum. Above, related to what is arises from the first inch of first part of the duodenum upward? Lesser omentum. And the passing transversely in the abdomen is the transverse colon. The quadrate loop related to three structures from below upward. Below is transverse colon. Above is first part of duodenum. Above is fold peritoneum arising from first part of duodenum, which is lesser omentum. We will know that the lesser omentum is attached below to the first inch of first part of duodenum, and above attached to the porta hiatus. Therefore, the fold peritoneum arising from the duodenum to the porta hiatus should be related to the upper part of quadrate lobe of liver. The quadrate lobe of liver related to three structures: transverse colon below, bilor duodenum and the first part of duodenum, and above to the porta hiatus is the lesser omentum. To the right side of the quadrate lobe of liver is the fossa for this organ. This is the gallbladder, which appear better here. This is the anterior surface of the liver, and I reflect the liver. Like in operation, in the operation for gallbladder, I put a retractor, and I draw the retractor upward to see this piriform structure on the inferior surface of the liver, which is gallbladder fossa on the inferior surface of the liver. To the right side of the gallbladder, there are two flexures. If this is the gallbladder, to the right side, there is two flexures. What is the first flexure? On the quadrate loop and the neck of gallbladder passing the first part of duodenum. After the gallbladder fossa, the first part of duodenum descend downward as second part of duodenum. Therefore, the flexure between the first part and second part of duodenum is adherent to the right side of gallbladder. Here, there is the duodenal impression, junction between first and second part of duodenum. To the right side of this flexure, the ascending colon arising upward, then passing transversely, resulting a flexure between ascending and the transverse colon. This flexure here is called the right colic flexure. And since this flexure is related to the liver, it is called also hepatic flexure of the colon. Actually, on me, when I return the liver to its normal position, on Wahdan, the ascending colon arising upward, then reflected to become transverse. At this reflection between ascending and the transverse colon, there is the right colic flexure here. Okay. The remaining part of the right lobe show a large concave area. This large concave area is related to right kidney, and therefore it is called renal impression. And if you connect the relation together, this is the area for the right kidney. And above this area, the bare area related to right suprarenal gland. And we all know that the suprarenal gland is just above the right kidney. Okay? Therefore, the inferior surface is related to, collectively, gastric impression, tuber omental, fissure 4, ligamentum teres, quadrate loop of liver related to three structures. Below, transverse colon. Above, bilateral duodenal junction and the first part of duodenum. Above, lesser omentum. To the right side is fossa 4, gallbladder. To the right side of the gallbladder, there are two flexures. Just in contact with the gallbladder is first and second part of duodenum. To the right side is right colic flexure. The remaining area is concave area, which is right renal impression. Okay. This is the impression on the liver. The liver, and I look from behind, I will see this piriform structure, which is gallbladder. The gallbladder has three parts. This part is fundus, body, and the neck. From the neck arises this green tube. What is this green tube arising from the neck? This is the cystic duct. The cystic duct meet what? Meet this structure, which is the common hepatic duct. This is the cystic, and this is the common hepatic. The meeting of the two ducts form this duct. This duct, which is common bile duct. Therefore, you will find here a Y-shaped junction. Y-shaped junction from gallbladder coming, cystic, from the hilum of the liver, from the porta hepatis coming, common hepatic, and the union of the two is the common bile duct. I put my hand here at the Y-shaped junction. From gallbladder cystic, from porta hepatis, common hepatic. And the union of the two is common bile duct. Okay. In this model, we see a C-shaped duodenum. The C-shaped duodenum. The first part of duodenum is removed, cut, and this descending part of duodenum is the second part. This horizontal third part, and the part arises here is the fourth part. Therefore, this is the second, third, and fourth part of the duodenum. Inside the C-shaped duodenum is the head of pancreas, and from the lower left part of the head of pancreas arises this process. This process which passing to the left side, which is called uncinate process. And related to these vessels passing in front of the uncinate process. This vessel is superior mesenteric vessels. The artery to the left side and the vein to the right side. Okay. After the head of pancreas, this the neck of pancreas, then the body, and the part in contact with the spleen is the tail of pancreas. This is the C-shaped duodenum, head of pancreas, and its uncinate process related to superior mesenteric vessels. After the head, there is neck, body, tail of pancreas. Okay.